The National Economic and Development Authority Board approved last week 12 projects with a combined worth of 133 billion pesos. The projects are aimed at addressing various needs in electricity demand, transportation, agriculture, and even climate adaptation. They include a 60 billion light rail transit line south extension project expected to be bidded out by early next month. So joining us this morning to tell us more about these approved projects and what we can expect from them is Socio-Economic Planning Secretary and NEDA Director General Cayetano Paderanga Jr. Secretary, I finally get to meet you in person. Good morning, sir.
Thank you very much, Pinky. It's my pleasure.
Thank you for coming over. I know you're very busy, but also very exciting, sir. 12
yes.
projects worth 133 billion pesos. Let's start with how this actually begins, just to give us an overview. These projects actually start from the ICC Technical Board.
Yes, although it starts from the agencies who propose it, and then the project proposal is vetted initially at the ICC Technical Board. Essentially, this is a committee of undersecretaries with their staffs, and they look at such things as the economic rate of return, mm-hmm. the beneficiaries, and then from there it goes on to the ICC Cabinet Committee, which essentially made up of about just a few agencies that it's chaired by the Secretary of Finance,
Secretary Purisima,
and then,
co-chaired by you?
Yes, by the NEDA.
Okay, so from there, from the ICC CABCOM, you basically lessen the number of projects that were forwarded by the ICC Technical Board.
Yeah. The biggest screening really happens at the Technical Board.
With the undersecretaries and all
With the
that.
Undersecretaries.
Basically, when it gets to you, it's already kind of compressed.
Yeah, they have the numbers.
Yeah.
There might be some things where things are just at the border, and so it will require the cabinet secretaries mm-hmm. to make the final decision.
And from the CABCOM?
And from the CABCOM, it goes to the NEDA Board for confirmation. The NEDA Board is chaired by the President of the Philippines, President Binigno Aquino, and that's the final.
Okay.
Now, after that, it then goes back to the Department of Finance for the financing aspects.
Yes. So it's a no. It's like it starts from, I guess it starts from point one and goes back to that point one too. It goes like full circle.
Yeah, it goes a full circle. And then after that, it goes to the implementing agency for implementation.
The ones who suggested and proposed the projects to begin with.
In the first place, yes.
All right. Okay, so again, we're talking about 133 billion. This is hopefully to spur the economy. There have been critics saying the president is not using the money. It's not spending enough. Now we're going to spend on. Please let us know what are the 12 projects. I have a list here, but so our viewers can understand better.
Oh yeah, if I may,
go ahead,
if you may, can I? The first one is the electric tricycles. This is really to help our conservation activities.
Right.
That's the aim there is to spread out 100,000 electric tricycles. They're in key municipalities who will have to agree to it. The first phase is only 20,000 e-trikes, and then on this basis we'll decide to go into the second phase. The next one is a very important one, especially with the electricity problems mm-hmm. in Mindanao, is the Agos 6 hydroelectric plant uprating. This is a 2.6 billion peso project to uprate existing plants, but in doing so we add 19 megawatts from 50 megawatts to 69 megawatts.
Right, we were talking about this yesterday with Undersecretary Asirit.
Yes.
Yes.
We need it very
yes.
urgently.
Although yeah. that 19 megawatts seems really small, but at least you're going to spend 2.6 here just to, it's really, Secretary, to kind of like upgrade it, renovate it, and
yes,
make sure the structure is going to be solid and won't be prone to any possible damages.
And also to make the turbines and the electrical generation facilities more efficient.
Right.
So with the same amount of water, you produce more energy.
Right. But a quick question, Secretary. Why just 19?
Well,
wasn't there a proposal?
That's the potential.
Hanggang
now
19
we have to now we have to go and get generating plants.
Okay. Yeah. Number three.
Number third is the Land Transportation Infrastructure and Information System. This is the LTO. project. And the aim here is to put together all the 300 LTO offices, put them into one, put a basic database.
Finally, sir.
Yes. Well, yeah. No, the idea, I think once this is done, DOTC will be, and the LTO, including our own police services and response services, will become much more efficient.
Exactly, sir. I can understand exactly how important that would be to have one database. For example, sir, this will be helpful, useful for carnapping,
yes.
Even suspected drivers, yes. Registration of cars, etc.
And it'll be difficult for drivers who have a bad mark to try to get under another name.
Okay. Yeah. So how much is going to be spent on that?
It's going to we're going to spend 11.4 billion pesos. But of course, you know, this will undergo bidding.
Yes.
And normally you get better value when you bid it out.
But when we were talking about that, I mean, it just reminds me of the past experience with the LTO. Remember,
that's right.
Sir, in trying to put together a database,
yes.
for the LTO, LTFRB, etc. So this is in the same mode, but this is going to be a new bidding process that will
right.
take place.
And the idea is you will get more value, more services. We will put together DOTC will put together the LTO records, LTFRB, and then also other relevant or complementary databases, mm-hmm. so that will be much more efficient.
So, okay. Number five.
Number five is a big one for Panay, the Halaur Multipurpose Irrigation Project. This is only the first part of what could be there are other trailing projects, but we're going to increase the irrigation of around 23,000 hectares. So we will get our. This is really for the food self-sufficient program that we're going into.
Yes.
And after this is done, through PPP they might even go into a water project and an electricity project.
Okay.
With the. A dam that will be built.
I see. Yeah. So a dam will be built here?
Yes, quite a high dam, and we will keep the water, so we will then be able to meter it out over the year.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The next one is the Umayan Irrigation Project. This is in Agusan del Norte. The idea here is we will also have more or less around 4,000 families help. Is to help them irrigate land. It will be financed. This is about 1.6 billion pesos.
Okay.
The third, the next one is still another irrigation project, but this time in Central Luzon. This will be in Bulacan, Nueva Ecija, Pampanga, and Tarlac, and it will cost us about 7 billion pesos. This is a big part of what could be several other projects. But
it just
right now
with
it's
this.
Irrigation. Yes. Okay. The seventh or is a bridge construction project called the Umiray Bridge.
Mm-hmm.
It involves the completion of the remaining about 51 kilometer unpaved sections for connecting the municipalities of Baler, Dipacolao. This is essentially in the province of Aurora.
Okay.
And it involves, I think. The financing here is from the Korean Exim Bank, the EDC.
Okay.
Then we have what's known as the one to help out the Pampanga area. It will cost about 4.7 billion pesos.
Mm-hmm.
It's really just to address the flooding problem in low-lying municipalities in the Pampanga Delta.
All right.
This is really an ODA loan from the Korean Exim Bank.
Okay.
Now, the big one, of course, is the LRT 1
yes.
South Extension Project.
Let's talk about that, sir.
It's about 61 billion pesos.
Mm-hmm.
And they are proposing 8 stations beyond Baclaran, which will go all the way up to Bacoor.
So, you're basically saying, sir, this was discussed already briefly by... I mean, it was in the news,
yes.
discussed by Secretary Mar Rojas. So that means from Baclaran, the LRT will be moving farther away up until Cavite?
Yes, Bacoor.
Wow, Cavite. Okay.
This is going to open up the whole South Corridor, where you already have a lot of people and economic activities. This we're quite excited about this.
Yes, it is exciting, sir.
Because it will serve... a few million, the estimate is that the first effect is about to immediately to have to benefit around 250,000 riders per day, and that's only the first hit.
Yeah.
There might be other connections that will be also affected, that will become more efficient.
Yeah, so that also will possibly ease traffic.
Yes.
Along the South Superhighway, because you'll have alternative routes.
Yes.
Alternative modes of transportation.
Very much, yeah.
Okay. When is the expected completion of this, the LRT extension?
Well, there will be several phases and they will build slowly. But I think the full completion is going to be around 2015. In fact, the president said that he would like to take the ride on the complete sections.
What, before he leaves office?
Yes.
Absolutely, of course. This will be his government's project. So we have projects on infrastructure, irrigation, electricity.
Yes.
I wanted to ask you, Secretary, with regards to, for example, the irrigation projects of the government, why were these the priorities?
Oh, because, number one, the president's program includes a very strong program on food security. And we want to make sure that we first try to achieve some level of some rice security, sustainability there. This also has a very large impact on low-income populations in the rural area. So it has some very nice benefits that has a very larger impact on the 16-point program of the President's social contract.
Yeah, but forgive me for asking this again. Why Panay, Bulacan, Nueva Ecija, Pampanga, Tarlac?
Those were the ones where there would be a lot of benefits, but also number two, which was more ready at that time. I think the government had been working on this for some time, but now things finally gelled in this administration, and we do have some of the resources that can now be applied to these projects.
Which among the projects are PPPs, sir?
The two immediate PPPs will be the DOTC projects, the LTO, the IT project, and the LRT extension will involve some. It will be structured. Some of it will be government production, and then there will be operations and maintenance. Then, of course,
just
at
like
the
latter
part of Halaor. Yes, just like MRT.
So two of them, and the rest are?
There will be ODA and some direct government implementations. Some of these projects actually have a significant amount of grant component. I think in the case of the Balerca-Siguran Road, there's a large, substantial grant component that brings down the cost to the government. But it's what is also important is that even like Halaur, there might be two succeeding projects that will be PPP. Well, the PPP projects, the rollout is going to be announced in time.
When?
in time.
Because that's also one of the, pinagmalaki din yan ng presidente, di ba, sir? And many have been asking, dun sa PPP, last I heard and last I remember, sir, there's been one or two PPPs?
There's already been two published. But this year will be the breakout year for the PPP.
That's what I heard last year.
Yes. No, last year NEDA was already saying that we need to have what they call properly prepared projects.
What were the two again, Secretary?
The first one is the Anghari.
Yes.
The second one is we've already published, but the bids still have to be opened. The first tranche of the 10,000 education classrooms.
Right. All right.
But
go ahead, Secretary.
Coming in are several projects. I think there's a vaccine production project of the DOH. This will be also PPP. And there
really? Vaccine project, PPP?
Yes. Well, it's essentially a production. It's a manufacturing facility. However, it has to be done under very stringent production conditions because you're producing drugs. But what this will do, it will bring down the cost of vaccines.
Yes.
And then
very
it
good.
Will also help us spread it out to the population faster.
So you're just looking at vaccines here?
Yes, just vaccines.
Okay, because we do have the cheaper medicines law that has been questioned by Senator Manny Villar, I think, saying that it doesn't seem like the cheaper medicines bill or law has been fully implemented. A quick question, Secretary, will these projects have an impact on economic growth?
Very much. Bringing 133 billion pesos just by the numbers to bear, it's not going to be spent all at one time. It's going to come in. But more important, it's going to draw in a lot of complementary investment from the private sector. I would think that people along the corridor in the south are already starting to think about what will happen just because LRT will be extended that way.
Yun palang, sir, hindi ba? You can expect, let's say, prices of lots to appreciate.
Probably
businesses
already has.
Once there.
Once it was announced.
Nihu ba? I know a lot of new villages after Ayala Alabang over somewhere in the Anghari that actually have increased prices per square meter. And even obviously business growth in those areas will expand.
I would think that the area around the Anghari interchange, probably the what they call the asking price, are probably already adjusted.
I know. Yeah. It was, if you were going to buy, you should have bought like a year ago.
That's right.
All right. Apart from this, the 12 projects, sir, what else is in the pipeline for NEDA?
There are several. It's hard to give the names now because then people will be expecting them. But there's a pipeline coming in. In fact, the informal agreement in the cabinet is to look at the president's schedule and see if we can schedule a follow-up NEDA board meeting sometime in April.
Oh, that's soon.
Yeah, but because of the Holy Week, it might be more towards the second half of April than the first half.
So are you talking about the next phase of NEDA projects?
Yeah, there are a few. You know, when we got the approval of 12 projects, those secretaries who had projects waiting on the wings have said, you know, we should have put ours in.
Paano kami? Oo, sayang. Just looking back at NEDA, sir, of course there have been controversial issues with NEDA in the past, but 12 projects worth 133 billion pesos in approved for the year 2012.
Yes.
Is this normal? Is this big or is this small?
This is big, especially for the start of the year, but we are also looking at taking up the slack from last year because we were changing the process, making it more disciplined and streamlined.
You weren't spending too much last year.
Well, they were also getting some savings, but yes, there was a review of some projects, I think, done by the agencies themselves. But now I think that we put in the process, together with the budget process being changed, I think first the approval and then the expenditure process is going to be much faster but also more efficient.
Anything really exciting coming up soon, sir?
In terms of projects?
Yes.
There's, I think that will be on the PPP side, but I will let the implementing agency secretaries and the PPP center make the announcement.
All right. A quick last question. I understand, of course, we all understand there's a problem in Mindanao right now. We extensively talked about this yesterday with two guests, Secretary Cheese and Yusek Asirit. You're looking at Agus 6,
yes.
You know, rehabilitating, expanding for an additional 19 megawatts. In the second phase, I'm interested to know, sir, is there something else that is in the pipeline for the power crisis in Mindanao?
Well, I'm just guessing from the outside because it will be the Department of Energy. But my impression is that there's a phase where they need to put in some rapid projects just to ensure security so that there will be less blackout, brownouts, and if not, take it out altogether. But then they will have to come in and talk about having what they call some baseload plants. The technical issue in Mindanao is that up to now, most of the sources of their energy came from what we would call cheap sources.
Hydro.
I mean, hydro is very cheap once you built the dams.
Yeah.
And now they will have to go into other forms that might increase the average cost. And this will require some preparation of the market.
And the worst would be the use of the barges.
That's right.
The most expensive.
Yes. Yeah.
Cheapest is hydro. I think most expensive would be the use of the barges.
Of what they call the use of bunker fuel.
Yeah. Well, all right. Well, we'll see what happens, sir, with the 12 projects. We look forward to this, especially. Obviously, because very clear sa atin yung LRT, di ba? That's something that we can all really look forward to because it's very close to our hearts. Malapit tayo dito. And we wish you luck, of course,
thank
sir, and of course
much.
The agencies that will be implementing this.
Oh, thank you.
And for the next phase, sir, we'll probably have you again.
Yes, thank you very much. Yeah.
All right, thank you so much, Director General of the NEDA, Secretary Cayetano Paderanga. Sir, thank you so much.
Good morning.
Good morning. Coming up, the Philippines will once again join the world's largest environmental movement. Paolo talks to the co-founder of Earth Hour after the break. Stay tuned. This is Mornings at ANC.